Ascribe to either meaning or meaninglessness. It is very prevalent in a way to the human condition. We have to put everything in the box of either it has this meaning or in the box of oh, this is meaningless. If these boxes, which we supposedly have used to answer the question why, which have built a box around us in a way. Most favorite ones, in fact, behind all why, in some ways, the why me. Why me? Or why not me? Also. From our limited perspective, you see, from our limited perspective, we cannot fathom the magnificence of this. Cannot even fathom what to exist mean. What does it mean to exist or not? But we want to fathom a lot after existence. How do I do something? Why does this happen? But all of that is after existence. So we don't know the basic foundation from our limited position as the mind, but we try to gather a lot of answers, and that and a collection of all of these answers is what we call a person. What is a person? Just a collection of all these answers that we've used to define ourselves in some way, that which we call a belief system or conditioning, is what? Just what we think we know. We start to believe that that is our experience, and that's why we feel like that is valid. But if you really check on your experience without trying to get to an answer, you will see that it's not true. Your experience is not that of separation. It is not that of separation. It is not that of limitation. It is not that of individuality. And what I might say after this might sound very unpopular, or might not be the best sounding words, but it is our attachment to our version of the truth, you see? And then we buy these ideas of, but it is my truth, it is my truth, you see? And that claim is just a defense of that which you are actually unsure about. That's why you have to keep claiming it. It is my truth, you see? This, because the me at the center of it is usually just the made-up thing, the made-up bundle of answers. Like we were talking about, all the answers, all the beliefs you have, all the things you think you know. So when the mind couches it in these terms, that but this is my truth, and we are human after all. You see, these kind of things, it's all lies. But they seem very attractive. What is your actual experience or insight? You looked and looked, did you find a human sitting there? And yet these concepts are attractive, not just in spirituality, but in all of humanity in a way. And anything that seems to be then contrary to the emotional ideas of separation and individuality, then no. But that is just some sort of a bypass, avoidance. That is just some sort of avoidance. But actually, that's why I've been saying over and over again that the only way I can find of avoiding what is to put my label, to put a claim of my knowing on top of it. So how can it be then that to remain motionless is a avoidance? How can it be that to meet what is in this moment naked is avoidance? To add the fig leaf of a notion would be avoidance. How can it be that you are meeting it completely open, is it, without any defenses of any labels, and that is avoidance? Is it? That is basically just saying that you have to believe some conclusion from the mind. Is it? To this idea that unless you buy some conclusion from the mind, you are in avoidance of something. This is just made up by the mind itself. Because I am saying, meet even this mind completely, fully. But check on what it is saying. See if it actually is pointing to the reality even of your phenomenal experience. Is it? See if it is actually pointing to something called a tree. See if there is something actually called tree. It's just a name, it's just a word. Everything is so alive and unique that we cannot meet life in that way. When we have a label for it, then it is to put it in our box of concept that I know what it is. This is tree. So we come to a point where we tire even of the most fancy notions. Most fancy, like pure. I'm using them to live my life. There comes a point where you see that I don't want to use anything at all. If life wants to live, then life can live. She said.
Example of fancy notion.
Yeah, like this, no? That I'm just living my truth because I'm human after all. Whatever it is, whatever you feel is like still very attractive and truthful to you. Whatever you are, in a way, allowing without investigation. Whatever it is buying without investigation. Whether, and especially that which you, the minute you want to investigate into that, the mind really starts to. Like that, you see? And in these kind of investigations, the mind will say, but that is going too far. That is going too far. After all, you came to satsang to become an enlightened person, is it? And you wanted to be a sage. Now look at what's happened to you. Like this kind of thing. You wanted just freedom. You wanted to have a happy life, which is free, is it, like that. And this one is saying, all of this is just the horn of a hare. What is this going on? Is it? Like, it's going too far. I think I need a break. This is like, is it? So. These kind of things, if we are open enough to investigate what is it we are defending, and if it is the truth, why does it need a defense? Is it? If it is the truth, why does it need to be defended? Is it? Because the truth will survive, is it? If you need to put a wall around it, then what must there be? Is it? Something that in your heart of hearts you know is not true. Is it? So you better put enough defense mechanisms. And sometimes very subtle things, like this one you're sharing with me in a way, and this has stayed with me in a sense. You know, like, okay, but like, really, let's get real, you know? Let's get real. Like, okay, so what then? We're just making things up in satsang every day about non separation, non duality, all of this is just. Like just fancy talk, is it? Because ultimately when it comes down to it, let's get real. This is, yeah. This. So what to say? Yeah. And this exactly the same thing, but in different words, is let's be practical now. Let's get practical. This is, right? Yeah, is it? But actually what we're saying is, let's get real. Because if we did not feel that that had a position in reality, we would not want to get practical. is it? So all this is duality. We get stuck in real, practical, yes, no, truth, false, up, down, all these kind of things. But it is all in denial of your actual experience, which is so alive and empty of limitation right now. Right now. It is only your trying to hold it, grasp it, cling at it, try to put it in a box. Then it seems elusive, and then you get frustrated, is it? But you don't need to hold it in the box. It is always here for you.
Om Shanti.